you gonna get a free Batman reference? Here we go.
How's one to know? I'd meet you where the spirit meets the bones in a faith forgotten land. In from the snow, your touch brought forth an incandescent glow, tarnished but so grand. And the old widow goes to the stone every day, but I don't, I just sit here and wait, grieving for the living. Oh, goddamn, my pain fits in the palm of your freezing hand.
Okay.
I wish to know the fatal flaw that makes you long to be magnificently cursed. He's in the room. Your opal eyes are all I wish to see. He wants what's only yours.
Yeah, so it's kind of like, I'm going to rewind it here, because it's kind of like this idea of that, like, yeah, you've resigned yourself to just be by yourself. You know, you are a house of stone. Your dreamland does not necessarily involve somebody else because you're heartbroken, and we've all kind of felt that way at the end of a relationship. But then somebody comes along and, you know, they start planting roots in your dreamland and taking up space in your mind and start covering you. You know, yeah, their ivy grows, and then you get attached to other people. I don't know, that's just life. And it's like, is that special because it happens over and over, or is it not special because it happens over and over? Is it special because it happens to you? So there's subjective specialness, but objectively, if you zoom out and see the world for what it is, maybe it's not special at all, but it's hilarious that everybody thinks it's special. I don't know, these are my thoughts. But regardless, I like the imagery, you know? Total, like, the Princess Bride vibes right now. Like, I'm just picturing Wesley in there saying, as you wish.
A house of stone, your ivy grows, and now I'm covered. Clover blooms in the field, spring breaks loose, time is near. What would he do if he found us out? Crescent moon, coast is clear.
Yeah.
How's one to know? I'd live and die for moments that we stole on begged and borrowed time. So tell me to run, or dare to sit and watch what will become and drink my husband's wine.
Lush. Like the little guitar.
It's a fire, it's a goddamn blaze in the dark, and you started it. You started it. So yeah, it's a war, it's the goddamn fight of my life, and you started it. You started it. Oh, 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 I can't stop you putting roots in my dreamland. My house of stone. Your ivy grows.
Good. I think I'm better prepared for the sound of this album, which is making it a lot easier for me to probably accept. And I don't know, maybe it's because I listened to Speak Now and I'm not so stuck on a pop sound right now, you know? Like when I was like going through 1989, which was like basically my introduction to Taylor Swift. That's like I just like thought that was the sound, and she's a pop star. This is pop music. It makes sense. So when she's not, and I'm liking it now, like I liked the 1989 music, you know what I mean? So for there to be such a drastic change maybe shocked me. And I'm still of the mind that just in a general sense, I prefer a variety on an album. I don't want all love songs, all anger songs, all random story songs. I don't want all heavy metal. I don't want all acoustic. I don't want all synth. I like a variety of sounds. I want to be able to stick with an album start to finish and not have it feel monotonous. So part of me wishes that we could get this more mature sound and layered storytelling in music with a variety of sound. But the fact that we're not going to get that doesn't bum me out as much as it did for Folklore, because like I said, I think I'm just more prepared for it. As far as like my favorite one or two tracks from this grouping, it's hard to pick, honestly. You know what I'll do? You know what I'll do? I will just say my least favorite, because it's pretty strong. Like so far throughout the first 10 tracks, I would say probably Gold Rush and Dorothea are probably the ones that I'm not going to remember the most. But like the rest of them, I like already like remember lyrics or remember melody or just remember feelings, which is really good considering it's just a first time listen. Like I've talked about in the Discord, I'm thinking about doing just a music podcast, a music focused podcast for the music channel, so that I can talk about these things a little bit more, and revisit songs, you know, because there's a difference between a first impression versus a lasting impression when it comes to like music reactions. My thoughts change a lot after a first reaction, depending, because you know, we meet music halfway with what's going on in our life and things change, time changes you, and you hear a song more and notice things, appreciate things you didn't hear, or things that you thought were really cool to start. When you re-listen to it, you're like, that's not that great. You know what I mean? So I don't know. But yeah, Dorothea is probably the one that I'll remember the least, but probably the rest of them. Yeah, Nobody, No Crime, and Happiness are definitely the top two. But I did also really like Coney Island and Ivy. Coney Island needed the Bon Iver singer, whatever his name is. Yeah, they told me that that's not his name. But still a good song. I would still listen to it. I'll just listen to that and then Exile right after. So, yeah, really fun breaking down the album like this, and I'm really enjoying getting to hear this music and talking about it, and I hope that you enjoy hearing my thoughts on it, and I hope that you have a conversation with me in the comment section. Thank you, I Love Manatees, for your support and for this request. I'm looking forward to continuing and finishing the main album tracks and then getting to the bonus tracks. If you like this video, like it, comment, let me know what are your favorite one or two tracks from this grouping, and just what are some of your thoughts on the thoughts that I shared. If this makes its way to YouTube someday, don't forget to subscribe. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.